Of activists are set to descend on Clermont in Queensland later this week as part of a Stop ADANI march protesting the Indian mining giant's controversial Carmichael Coal Mine. Locals, though, are not planning a warm welcome, some refusing to serve activists in their pubs and their cafes. And there to shake things up even further is One Nation leader Pauline Hanson, who is driving this car through the main street with the message "Pauline digs coal" displayed on its side in support, of course, of the coal industry. And Pauline Hanson joins us now from Clermont. Pauline, good morning to you. We know that you never back away from a fight and you're taking it straight to the protesters. What sort of reception are you expecting?
Well, actually, I won't be here on Saturday when the protests are expected to arrive. I'm coming through Queensland on tour of Queensland and via Clermont because to show my support for the mining town. There's not one person that we've come across in a span of a few hours that say they don't want ADANI not to go ahead. So the town needs it. They need jobs in central Queensland. It's very important that ADANI goes ahead, and the town desperately needs it. They don't want to see these extremists come up here from probably down in Victoria or Sydney or wherever they come from. They have no relationship to the town, and I think it's absolutely disgusting what they're trying to do. They've actually come up in here and saying to people, well, if you've got your businesses, you own a business up here, a motel, whatever, well, I'm sorry, just sell up, get out of the place because there's no future for you.
Well, climate change is at the core of these protesters. Are you not concerned at all about the impact that global warming is having on Queensland?
Deb, there's no scientific fact to all this, and we've even got...
Do you deny then that climate change is real, Pauline?
The Australians are... No, Deb, let's just put the facts here. A lot of scientists have come out, even Peter Reid, Professor Peter Reid from the Cook University, he said the reef is not dying. There's no, you know, peer reviews of these scientists.
Well, climate change we know, though, Pauline, is hitting farmers hard. Hard-working people on the land who you say you are a voice for, they're suffering through droughts, through floods, through major weather events, and a lot of farming groups are on board saying that we do need to curtail carbon emissions.
Deb, this has been a fact of life right from the time that Earth was here in place, that we've been going through climate changes in Earth. There was once an ice age, there was once a flood throughout Australia here, water. It was all through central Australia.
I didn't think you were a climate change denier,
though, Pauline.
People weren't around
at that time. We didn't have the industrialists here in this country at that time. There has been changes. What happened to the dinosaurs? How did they die off? Humans didn't create it. So there's been a lot of changes that have happened. They haven't released the true facts of figures as far as temperature changes over the years. They've fiddled with facts and figures. This has been man-made, this fear-mongering about climate change. If climate change is happening, it's not because man-made is causing it to happen. We've got volcano eruptions that actually, you know, spew out more carbon emissions than and even the oceans do.
All right.
Don't put it down. Don't destroy people's lives, industries, manufacturing in a country, and we're destroying our future.
I'm not sure what the scientists would say to that, but in terms of One Nation and the support you're getting, what's going on with voters in Queensland in particular? New polls show that you and your party are losing support, primarily to Clive Palmer and to Bob Katter. Have you lost your mojo, Pauline?
The true polling day is on election day, Deb, all right?
But are you concerned
so
at all about...
Let's just see how people vote on polling day, you know? And that's the true day of voting.
Are you concerned at all, though, about voters leaving One Nation? Because we know that Clive Palmer, he's polling at 14% in Herbert, the key seat in Queensland. Bob Katter's on 10%. And One Nation, your supporters nosedive to 9%. This is your heartland.
People have actually, Clive Palmer's put out $31 million in advertising.
And it's resonating.
Of course that's going to cut through. And how on earth can you actually compete with that? But if you look at Clive Palmer last time in Parliament, he was a non-event. He actually folded his part. People walked away from him. Clive Palmer's in for Clive Palmer, not for the Australian people. And I hope people see through that as well and look at what I have been able to achieve for Queensland in the last 3 years. So I'll base it on that. I'll let the people know. Who do they really trust? So let the people have their say on election day.